don't think about it too much.
What's up, YouTube? It's Tuesday. I don't know the date. October something. I don't think I've experienced racism specifically within the queer community. I can't say that I have. Racism is just so prevalent in society that it kind of makes its way into all aspects. So I am not saying that racism doesn't exist within the queer community, because I feel like it does. It has to, because it's in us as people, unfortunately, as a society, as far as the United States is concerned. So the idea of some sort of racism that's unique to queer individuals is not something I'm familiar with. What I will say is that I feel like within the queer community, there is a lot of separation. There's a lot of them versus us. There's a lot of just a lot of conflict. And I know that as far as race goes, the Human Rights Campaign has gotten some negative attention over the years for what has been perceived as them favoring equality for the cisgendered white people within the LGBTQ community. And it's unfortunate. It's unfortunate that we as queer people have to overcome so much as it is, that we can't find that commonality and join together. There's always a division of white queerness deserves more respect than people of color queerness. And that's unfortunate, and I think that's what people were getting at as far as the Human Rights Campaign. I have experienced this line drawn between myself and the rest of the queer community. There's been lines drawn between this channel and trans women. There's been a line drawn between this channel and channels that don't have people of color on them. I think it speaks volumes that we felt compelled to create this channel just to get our voices out there, just to offer support to people who look like us throughout our transition. I wouldn't say it's racism per se, but it's definitely a racial issue within the trans community, where there's just not much out there for whatever reason for people of color. Sadly, I think we're used to it. I think we're used to kind of gathering the crumbs of what we can to make something out of it. I think we're used to going to YouTube and sifting through video upon video upon video of the white trans man experience, because that's what's out there. And I think for some reason, we have felt like that's okay. There's nothing wrong with us having to kind of infer how things would happen with us through their eyes. So I think it's so important that we created this channel to provide that resource for people of color. We are out here. Our stories are just as relevant. Our stories need to be heard just as loudly as the non-people of color. And that needs to be known, and I think that needs to be expressed. So while I haven't experienced racism directly from the queer community, I have definitely seen that there is a racial divide, I guess I would say. And hopefully through us making these videos each week and being here and being visible and being available, being approachable, we are attempting to close that gap. We didn't create this channel just so that people of color can watch. We created it so that everyone can see. Everyone can see that we're all going through the similar things. We really are. Things are similar, but there are situations that are specific to people of color that also need to be discussed, also need to be presented and valued. And for me, I think that's what's so important about this channel. Race within the queer community. These are my opinions. Do what you want with them. Peace.